Regarding leadership, we need to realize that there are two types of leaders. Those who are born leaders and those who worked so hard to become leaders. In the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they were always meant to be leaders, but they worked much more than others. If you're born into a family where sometimes they've already led, say in a business or in anything. When we talk of leadership, we're talking of all levels of leadership, starting from leadership within the home and taking it beyond into an entire nation and perhaps even beyond that. So sometimes you have people who are fortunate to have had this life from the beginning where they were exposed to so many different factors and people because of leadership within the environment they were born into, their homes or sometimes those whom they associated with. Whereas in the case of a lot of people of the globe who have become leaders, they were not necessarily born within such a circle. They were not fortunate enough to have leaders within their homes. So they studied, they worked hard, but they had a vision. Someone, somehow, somewhere happened to perhaps encourage them, guide them, be a role model for them, that encouraged them to propel to that position. Focus was absolutely important. I find in my own life, I've had a father to look up to, who's also a leader in his own right, a great role model. And I find that that was a gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To this day, I have a father figure. Alhamdulillah, he's still alive. He lives with me. He corrects me. And that's something I've learned, to be a leader. Never shy away from being corrected. If you notice my life, I have over the years softened. I have perhaps learned that if you want to lead, you need to develop relationships with those whom you differ with. That is actually one of my goals. Someone I really disagree with, I need to get along with him because the commonalities and the common factors are so great, yet they are ignored. It's something I've learned. And if those of you who might have studied my life or who might have followed me for the last 20 years perhaps, you will notice that in the last 10 years, you know, things have changed because we've learned what we did not know before. And you learn up to the point of death, but it's no good to just learn. If you're a leader, you implement the best of that learning, not just any of the learning, the best of it, in a way that sometimes you might modify and perhaps come up with something that is greater than what you've actually learned to be able to teach it to others. And there is no harm. In fact, we should be discussing it with people, movers, shakers. I mean, I like that term, movers and shakers, because when you discuss what is within your heart sincerely with those who are sincere, you come up with new strategy. You arrive on a new level. You come up with solutions. And that's what makes you the leader. That's what makes you a person who leads, because you're different. I remember when I started, I took a lot of flack for some of the standpoints that I had. I can give you some simple examples, obviously, in my circle, where using technology to its extent was at one stage considered taboo by some in my fraternity. But I never ever looked back. I took the flack and I carried on. And I recall there was a time when I too thought that perhaps, you know, it's taboo. I recall when Facebook actually gave a platform to those who wanted to blaspheme the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. People were anti-Facebook, stop using it. You know, when YouTube had something, a video against Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, people said, stop using YouTube. And initially, I thought about it. I even spoke about it in one of my lectures. And very quickly, I had a businessman, not even in my field, but he was a sincere brother. He came to me, he said, Sheikh, I think you're making a mistake. I said, well, what is it? And this goes back to leadership. A leader is supposed to listen very carefully to those who are sincere and genuine, no matter who they are. They could be off the street, in all honesty. They may come up with a bright idea that will change your life. So he says, you know, these are platforms. Have you studied them carefully? Do you know you can use them to counter exactly what you are trying to run away from right now? And I thought about it and I said, you know what? It's right. Subhanallah. And I started using it in a positive way, bearing in mind that these platforms do not belong to Muslims. They belong to human beings. So you need to respect the others, those whom you differ with. And you need to try and present in such a way that you haven't compromised your position, but you've respected the position of the others. So as we grow and as we learn, we would actually be able to develop even beyond those who inspired us at times. When people say, I'd like my son to be like you, I say, no. In my field, I say, aim for the Sahaba, radiallahu anhum. Aim for the companions. Who am I? I am a flawed individual. Perhaps you may be inspired. But if you aim for me, you know, you might get somewhere that is not a very good place. Aim higher so that you get somewhere, inshallah. May Allah make it easy. So the point I wanted to raise was, we need to not blame the environment we're in to say, well, he was a born leader. No, there are leaders, and the majority of leaders have worked hard to become those leaders. And I think we all need to work very hard, be dedicated, focused, have, for example, role models, have people, mix with people who inspire you. I always say, mix with positive people. And sometimes people say, well, you know, the negative ones, if we mix with them, won't we, you know, who will be in the good and who will be in the bad? Who is positive, who is negative? If the negative people think, I want to mix with positive people, and they're mixing with positives such that the positives begin to think they are negative, you never mix with each other. You never interact. So what you need to do, look at who is having an impact on who, and you will be able to tell whether it's the positive force that is winning or the negative one.
Thank you so much. Wonderful.